Hello friends, welcome to Introduction of Signals and Systems. Let's discuss even and odd signals. Even and odd signals are classified like this. A signal x of t is said to be an even signal if x of minus t is equal to x of t, and a signal is said to be an odd signal if x of minus t is equal to minus of x of t. So these are the classic example of even signal and odd signal. Cos of t represents an even signal because cos of minus t is equal to cos of t, and sin t represents an odd signal because sin of minus t is equal to minus of sin of t. Here we can observe some important points about an even signal and odd signal. Even signal always have a symmetry about y-axis, that means it is mirror image with respect to y-axis, and an odd signal always have a symmetry about the origin and it must have zero value at the origin. Let's see the expression for even and odd part of any arbitrary signal. Any arbitrary signal x of t is said to be a combination of its even and odd part. Let's say we have a signal x of t, then it is a summation of its even part and odd part. Now by using the time reversal property, if we write the expression for x of minus t, then we know for even signal x of minus t is equal to x of t, and for odd signal x of minus t is equal to minus of x of t. Hence we can rewrite this expression, and from equation 1 and 2 we can compute the expression for even and odd part of any arbitrary signal. So these formula can be used for computing even and odd part of any arbitrary signal x of t. Let it understand by an example. If we have a signal x of t, then x of minus t can be drawn by taking mirror image with respect to vertical axis, and then the even part of the signal can be computed by adding these two signal and divide it by 2. So hence we get the even part of the signal. And for odd part of the signal, subtract these two signals and divide it by 2, hence we get the odd part of the signal.